sisters and our friends say that. In the first place, I give glory, honor, and praises to Jehovah, the Almighty God. And this belongs to Jesus Christ for the privilege we have to do them service this morning. Indeed, there is no better place for us to be this morning. I am joined and elated. I thank the Appreciative Minister, as well as other members of the Appreciative Committee, the Youth Fellowship Committee, for giving me this privilege. My talk this morning is simply to remind us and to charge us in connection to the Youth Fellowship launching coming up next Sunday, 6th of June 2021. In line with what the Station Minister said, or in line with the sermon for today's divine service, and what shall we render out to the Lord for all his benefits towards us? I know this garden is not a garden of youths, but I'll spend the indulgence of the Station Minister to charge us with the youth's slogan. Up youths!
Action!
Up youths!
Action!
Action in Christ! Youth motto. Thank you very much. In remembering our Creator in the days of our youth, we have another opportunity next Sunday by God's grace to come before Him and to showcase or to give gratitude and thanks to God Almighty. I understand the country is currently difficult. We are having a lot of economic challenges. Some persons might ask, what then is the essence of this country? Considering that the triennial assembly has been cancelled. But I want to charge us that there are other welfare activities. The last one we did in 2019, members can attest to the fact that the Youth Fellowship did a lot of welfare activities. Even in the branch today, there are a lot of projects. A member painted this service hall. What stops us as youths to come up with projects that we can do in the service of God? So we shouldn't just limit ourselves to the fact that because the triennial assembly has been cancelled, there is no need for this launching. The Bible tells us in Proverbs 11, verse 24 and 25, that there is he that scattereth and yet pleaseth. And that there is another person, a category of persons that we told more than his needs, and such persons tended to poverty. I won't take too much of our time because we know some of these things already. But with the permission of the Appreciative Minister, I would like us to read Ecclesiastes 11, verses 1, 4, and 6, please. Ecclesiastes 11, verses 1, verse 4, and verse 6, please. And I'll be done.
Cast thy bread upon the waters.
Cast thy bread upon the waters, yes.
But thou shalt find it after many days.
This is the preacher saying, thou shalt cast thy bread upon the waters. Ordinarily, if you throw bread into water, it's going to dissolve. It's going to turn into nothing. The Bible is telling us that we should cast our bread upon the waters. In other words, the figurative term. In our service to God, whatever we do in it, it is not lost. We are going to find it after many days. Carry on, please.
He that observeth the wind shall not sow.
And he that observeth the wind, some of us might say, we have donated for the St. Robert Square launching, we have donated for the branch launching, we have done this, we have done that. We are observing the seasons when we do so. Carry on, please.
And he that regardeth the clouds shall not weep.
And he that, carry on, say that again, please.
And he that regardeth the clouds shall not weep.
He that considereth the clouds shall not weep, yes.
In the morning sow thy seed.
In the morning sow thy seed, yes.
And in the evening we don't know thy hand.
In other words, whenever we have the opportunity, we should have our hands in the work of God, yes.
For thou knowest not whether thou shalt prosper.
Because we don't know the one God Almighty will use. In blessing us, yes.
Either this or that. Or whether they both shall be alike good.
And so whether we have the funds to come or not, for just being in the service that day and waiting behind, you should support those who have the funds to donate. If you have, please do so. Just like the minister said, the widow who gave her widow's mite, not because she gave the largest amount, but because she did it from her heart. She did it from the depth of her heart. So I want to encourage all you. Come next Sunday, 6th of June 2021, is the Youth Fellowship launching for the branch. Let us all come prepared. The target is 1 million naira, and I believe by God's grace that we are going to hit that target and surpass it. Thank you all for listening.